the night before the trip, and we're having problems with the Mavic Pro battery. It's not, like, it's knackered, basically. There's been quite a few people online that have had this problem. We're quite fortunate that this problem has happened on the ground and not while it's been in the air. But we are currently, right now, trying to drain the battery down to see if we can repair it. So we're both sat in the living room, having a couple of beers, listening to this.
It's not good.
Morning. Steve's still in bed. Steve's just woken up yet. He's awake! Checking it, digging it!
Sending the customary text to the wave.
Of course. Love you, miss you, all that.
Oh,
it's pretty nasty out there. It's toast time. Time for some toast. Find a place to have a biblical breakfast. And what we've done this time as well is we've already donned said waterproofs so that we don't have to do it when we get out of the car or in the car, hence making steamed up carriage with two men with no trousers on, which we don't want to do that again. Anyway, I've decided we're going in your car.
Not going in my car.
Of course we are. Your car's so much better than mine.
We get these in that.
Of course we are. Of course we are. We'll do it. Come on. Easy done. Get your keys.
That's not gonna work.
But Steve, I wanna go in your car!
That's unexpected. That's it.
Does it shut? Does it shut? Oh! We're just going to switch the engine on and let you have a listen to the exhaustage. Because it's, I know it's nothing to do with camping, but it's biblical. Right. So.
Yeah, we're off. Found it now.
We're back.
In
on track.
200 metres, turn right.
Turn that off. Right now.
No, because that'll be funny. That's just going to annoy you.
Yeah. So.
I'm hungry.
I'm really hungry now. It's
turn
destination.
Right.
It's destination. Kirby train station.
Across the nation.
To get some breakfast.
At a station.
Station. Mastication. Which is chewing, ladies and gentlemen. There's been an issue, hasn't there? But we'll tell you about that a little bit later on. But
what issue?
The issue with the drone. But now I've told them, haven't I?
That issue.
I said later on.
We're not good at that. We videoed that last night.
Yeah, no, I'm going to put that in at the time that. Oh, hard work you are sometimes. In front of the sky guy now.
Right. We've driven 4 miles. 4 miles. And it's total pea soup at 60 feet.
It really is, isn't it? This is, hopefully, we can get above it though.
So,
2,500.
I think it's safe to say. Yeah. This one's going to be foggy.
We have arrived. What's it called? The country harvest?
Should know that by
heart. Should do, yeah, come here every time. We've been here probably about 17 times now. It's 59 quid that, boys and girls. 59 quid. You can have that. They're all 59 quid.
Oh,
you can have a badger or a cock. So, well, just so you know, price wise, the price of the. Breakfast comes to, what is it, £26,
£27,
three and a half pence. It's such an odd number. Such an odd number. Not in here. Not in here.
Never fart on a wooden chair in public.
It's not going to be a dry one, is it, Steve?
No.
It's very, very windy. Well, open the door. That's not good.
There we go. I'm out! Don't care!
We are parked at Scales, just up from the pub at the bottom. And we're heading pretty much straight up. It's a big hill, and it's straight up. I mean, there's no denying. He's been out for a second. There is no denying.
Oh, come on, open your window. That's bad.
He won't open because you told me to turn the ignition off.
God. Oh, that is bad. It's just not going.
Full Felbab coming up. Anyway, for the first... Right, in 1 kilometre, we'll have walked 621 metres high. In just 1 kilometre.
Oh, brilliant.
Yeah, so it's going to be warm, straight up. Big shout out to the guys who make these t-shirts at the British Mountain Enthusiast. There will be a link in the description below to go see them. They help the mountain rescue team. Some of their payments for the t-shirts go towards. Make a bit more noise with your crinkly bag.
All right.
Steve's got a t-shirt, but obviously he forgot his. There's always something. Of course, you forgot it.
Sort of. Found it.
Right then, guys. See you in a bit.
Bye!
Steve's new coat, Berghaus, waterproof. How much was it? £10, just in case the wives watch this. So we've come this far, we've taken off the cover. We're getting a bit of steamage going on in the inside the housing, so we've taken it off. I don't know if you can see all this here, but this is all slate and stuff. So what I'm going to do right now is, there you go, I'm just slating Steve. It just pours out of me. There's the genius. Down there, as beautiful as that looks, coming up this path and down there, no wind at all, was there, Steve?
No, it was quite shielded there.
So we're thinking of camping on this side, on the lee side, when we go up, when we do find the space, but this side's slightly different. Now we've crested that first hill. And buffeting.
Buffeting!
We do it for you guys, we do it for you guys. Maz. Oh, he's done it. Just fully, I just spanked that. Steve, that is lovely.
Nice, that.
Well, we'll sort of let you into half the secret now, but Steve's basically shooting for a purpose now. And I don't mean shooting for a purpose as in he's taking photographs to look at them. He has got a really special way of editing them. And we shall, further on in the video, we'll pop up. Wind. We shall pop up some pictures later on of his composite images that he makes. Honestly, they are surreal. Surreal is an understatement as well,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah. Nice. You really think it'd be interesting to see what your comments are.
Yeah. Just never ends. The fun never ends. Not good.
Please.
But yeah, brilliant, yeah.
Top of a lorry on the M1.
Yeah.
Uphill.
We have had issues, haven't we, Steve?
Just a few.
All the issues known to man, and I'm going to just explain one of them to you now. Normally, the camera is attached to my stick. This one here, as you can see, not attached to the stick, because it broke! He snapped off because I fell over. Again.
Well, you didn't fall over, you sort of launched.
Yeah, well, launched by the wind. The wind has been ridiculous. This is the least windiest part, and it's still blowing us around a bit. Up there is bonkers. It is ridiculous, isn't it?
It's windy.
We're over at Bannerdale Crags now. And in the last few seconds, that's just opened up, which is beautiful. And I'm glad we walked all this way, just to see that. That's nice.
It would be really nice on compass today.
Yeah. Worthwhile coming over, guys. Right, see you in a bit. Bye. It's wind. Guys, I don't know if you can hear me. We found a pretty nice spot. Steve just set his tent up. We've got his own little house. We've got a stream. It's rock and roll central. Nanos. Right then, guys, we are camped. Apologies for the lack of videoage during the day. It's been horrendous. It genuinely has been horrendous. The wind, I have never experienced wind so strong in my entire life. And I don't mean bodily function wind, because we've also had that as well. But I mean general wind. It was ridiculous. Having said that, I'm boiling over. There we go. What do you do with really hot boiling water on top of a burning thing? You just put a gas on top of it. Yeah, that'll do. That'll stop it. Don't do that. I'm not advising that. The walk was lovely. It was really nice. I don't think we went too high. I think we only went about 600 metres high. But the big walk's tomorrow, when we do Blencathra, and then back down to the car. So today's been tough because it's kind of moors. It's more moors than it is lake. Of course. Now I want to make this. The steam from my cooking is blocking my face out. Excellent. I'll carry on. The moors. If you imagine being on Emly Moor or Yorkshire Moor or something like that, it's really boggy and moory. More, you know what I mean? It's not very good camping ground. It's not very good. It's really exposed. We're on Mungrisdale Common at the moment. We just come past the summit cairn, and it's lovely. It's almost like perfect for wild camping. But with the wind, it's been ridiculous. It's so exposed. We'll get out after we've had our food and do some photographs, and we'll show you where we are, and it's pretty special. It's stopped raining, the sun's come out. I think we're going to get a nice sunset, which is going to be lovely. That is really red. That's full steamage, is that? It's like a sauna in here. We pitched a tent right where you should never pitch a tent, and I genuinely mean that, because this was the only place we could find at the time, which just makes it more fun and more interesting for you guys. But we're literally right next to a stream that looks like it could get quite big should the rain start. So we put a few markers in the stream just at the edge. And if we notice that water's moving closer,
then we're going to have to up sticks and move. That's quite interesting. But again, I'll show you, as soon as I've had my food, as soon as we've had a bit of a replenish of energy.
Wind!
What?
Wind is doing my head in!
Wind is doing his head in.
All day.
It's literally battered our faces. I think I've lost about 2 years worth of skin from the Karcher.
It's getting stronger, isn't it?
It's getting stronger, yeah. The Karcher. I'm only calling the wind and the rain today the Karcher because that's what it felt like on my face. So yeah, all good. And yeah, we'll see you in a bit. Take care, bye! It would seem that the wind is getting worse.
Definitely.
We're not worried, we're just... we're a little bit worried. in preparation, what we decided to do is we'll just open the wine.
Colt, it's going to be a sunset and a half.
Is it? Wait a minute, let me open. Is it going to be nice?
That way.
All right. We were planning on camping in here. But the problem is, it's a big problem. This reed is really long. And we don't want to sort of stamp it down.
That cloud?
Which one?
Look at it.
It
literally looks like it's just coming to rain on us.
It's one of those comedy clouds. Just bringing rain to us.
It's going to get full star, is it?
There's no... See, he's gone again. He can only take so much of it outside, then he has to go back in again to get warm. Unlike me, that's obviously all man outside, just sucking it up. What else could I be doing right now? Steve cannot feel his genitalia.
Oh.
What are you doing?
God, it's cold.
Oh.
God, it is so... That is piercing, isn't it?
It is. It's just dirty in your face.
And the fact it's clear skies as well, it will probably drop to minus values anyway. Factor in a nice, comforting 50 mile an hour wind.
Yeah.
Just to top you off, basically. I wake up with icicles hanging out my ears.
Yeah. It's like the opposite of the tent giving birth.
Now we're already heavily thermaled up, so I thought I would mention the effect that's hitting us today more than any of the other trips we've been on, and that is wind chill. And the wind chill forecast today was -9, so despite the fact that it's probably about realistically 4 or 5 degrees plus positive temperature today at the moment, it genuinely does feel at -5 at the moment. Wind chill is a major effect, so it's hurting today. It's really, really hurting. I mean, we were lucky that we've now got the kit sorted to the extent that heavy rain just doesn't affect us anymore. Everything's dry. That's important to us. That's brilliant. That makes a huge difference. But it doesn't negate walking for 3 hours into 50-60 mile an hour winds that's just hammering you. you get cold. And now we've pitched, the wind is just not relenting at all. It's not relenting at all. The weather forecast today was spot on. You won't hear me say that very often, but it was spot on. It's stopped raining at least, it's clear now. But it's genuinely slightly unnerving now because you can't simulate testing a tent in wind really. So even though we've done a good review of this tent, we couldn't review it in 50-60 mile an hour winds, and that's what we're going to get tonight. So yeah, slightly unnerved because we've basically done everything wrong, which I don't mind admitting. The pitched in the wrong direction. You should never really put them side onto the prevailing wind, which we've had to do because we go side by side, obviously, for making these videos and for the social side of things. And we're pitched near a stream, which you should also never ever do. So do what we say, not what we do, probably is good advice here. It's we've done this before, so we know roughly what we're doing. But so yeah, we'll keep a close eye on that stream, but we're high now, you see, so most of the time that the streams don't get that much bigger at the height. As they go lower down, obviously, that's when you start to see the flooding. So we'll keep a close eye on that and just hope that the winds don't get up too much more. But it looks like, for the first time in three camps, it's going to be clear enough tonight to get some decent photography. If I can pull myself out of this tent. It's so cold. All right, guys, we'll see you soon. Bye.
Morning, everything's packed. Steve's got his tent away pretty much. He's got mine to do, sort of do the morning hello. The tent's got a batter in last night, full batter in, 60-70 mile an hour winds, and they are still there, which is good.
Always nice.
Always nice to know when you wake up in the morning that your house and your shelter is still available. We sort of had a bit of a lie-in this morning because we're a bit remote. We're not even on a walker's route, nowhere that anyone would go. And so we thought we'd just enjoy the moment and just be here and just, yeah, just relax. It's about 9:45. The path is up there. Up there. So we've got to scale this bit here, get up there and then go up that way. The sleeping bags, I think, mainly the reason why we didn't want to get out of bed, because they are so nice. We really enjoyed that. I think the magic number for wine is just the 1.5 bottles, not two. I think two is just a half a bottle too much, definitely. On a more positive note, I have broken my felt bab verging status. So I'm now no longer a Felbab virgin, or Felbidge virgin, so thank you very much. I can hear you all applauding and you're all happy to know that I've done that. I'll not show you it, obviously. However, I think it's time to start packing and start walking. Not going to be using my walking stick, because it's broken. So I'll be using what's left of it. And yeah, time to crack on. Hurts, doesn't it? You might not be able to hear us in the wind, but we camped just about there and walked all the way up here, and we've still got that to go. And
it's really hard work today. Really, really hard work. It's just leaving the camp spot semi-tired. Straight into a 1-in-3 for a mile.
Yeah. Closing statement, guys. The reason we didn't do a closing statement on the way back is A, it started raining again. B, we were shattered. And C, we were shattered.
Yeah.
Honestly, this walk has been a tough one, hasn't it?
I think it's been the toughest.
Really? I would say easily the toughest walk we've ever done. I've really still got my neck scar, that's why I feel a little bit warm. Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. So, we'd recommend massively a change of clothes with you if you come out and it's going to be damp for at least one of the days.
I would recommend not coming out if it's forecast to be windy.
Oh, yeah.
The wind...
That
brutalised that walk.
It did. I feel like I've lost... like bits of skin.
It was savage. Yeah, absolutely savage. We've got hardly any amazing photographs because, well, all you could see was cloud.
Yeah, it's been shocking. Yeah.
We walked probably a good 20 to 30% further than we were supposed to do because you simply couldn't camp. You just couldn't get anywhere where we had made a plan. We had to walk right up the side of another mountain and down into a valley to try and get ourselves out of the wind. So, and then this morning, having to climb back up it.
I mean, we videoed a little bit. That climb, every time we do a brutal climb like that, it finishes us off for the rest of the day. We did it on one of the last ones, didn't we? When we decided not to go on path, off path and up directly.
Oh, yeah.
And that finished us off. Yeah. That was,
It never seems to get any closer. You just keep looking at where you're supposed to be going and it just never gets any nearer.
Yeah, having said that, it's proper coming down now.
Yeah. Timing's been good. Weather forecast was spot on.
Yeah, the weather.
Amazing.
Start, yeah.
Absolutely spot Never on. It happened. Said it was going to start raining again today around about 2 o'clock-ish.
Yeah.
And it has. But, yeah. Enjoyed it, as always. Enjoyed it.
Very muddy.
Very hard work.
Yeah.
Very hard work, that one.
The spot, I think I'll remember that camping spot for the rest of my life. That was really nice.
It saved us, didn't it? Yeah. And the stream went down overnight. We didn't have any problems. The wind... didn't blow the tents away.
No.
Which was also good.
Well, as soon as I put bricks down on mine, the wind stopped.
Yeah.
Obviously.
So now, there's only one thing to do.
Cheese sandwich!
Speed on, Cole.
I'm off. Ladies and gentlemen, for the first time ever, we've not had to compromise on said sandwiches. We have found genuine cheese sandwich.
Plain white bread, no butter, and rubbish cheese.
Yeah.
Perfect.
That's what
That's
you
what
need.
That's what makes it happen.
I also bought an egg sandwich, steak and ale pie, a small bag of quavers, quite large, and Mars bar duel. It's cheese sandwich time. It's just cheese sandwich central, this.
That is legendary.
Where is that? We pulled up into a cafe because it says arts, food, play, shops. Got in there and it was just one shelf.
And a building site.
And a building site, yeah. Mm. Here we go. Oh.
It's special, isn't it?
It's the only way. Oh.